Okay, everyone, so before we will start, let us pray first. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, Amen. Almighty and ever-living God, we praise and glorify your name. We thank you for the countless blessings that you have bestowed upon us, especially the gift of life. We hope and pray that you send forth your Holy Spirit in each one of us, so that we may continue to do what you will us to do. This we ask through Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Okay, so good afternoon, or good evening, I know, kasi 6 p.m. na. Good evening, everyone. Welcome to our second meeting. So sorry for my voice, no? Okay. Napaos ako due to my sore throat. So, I will not actually, the lesson will be up until 8 p.m. Actually, ang slides, but I cannot really endure until 8 p.m. since the klase ko since morning pa. That's why medyo sore ako ang... I had sore throat already last week, pero mas ninglala siya as nag-klase ko whole day since morning until karon nga evening. No? So, just please bear with me if there are times nga I would lose my audio because I will mute myself and then probably drink water, no? Kay todo jud kasakit ang ako ang throat. But still, no, let us just prevail. Masking makaklase lang kunyog an hour and a half so that we can start with module 1. The rest, we can either finish it as soon as maayo naman ta, no? We can finish it as soon as I get well. I will finish the entire discussion next Monday and then give you an activity as well so that we can have some few bases for your grades po, no? Kaya last time, I had few activities. That's why medyo struggle ko asa mo kuha og for your additional grades. So, it's important that we have activities not only to synthesize what you have learned from my discussion, but as well as to also add for your, like, sa grades, no? You have bases as well. Okay, let me just share my screen. By the way, congratulations to UNESCO. It's now State University of Northern Negros, no? So, hindi na ta mo tawag niyag UNESCO, but you will call it Sun. Sun is rising in the north. At me. And it's very timely because our discussion today will be the history of UNESCO. So this is not the updated version pa. But syempre madungaga naman siya, no, kay with the school being a state university na. But the previous the previous events are still the same. Okay. If you can still remember in our discussion of the course syllabus, di ba, we already stated that in the course syllabus, we're going to learn about UNESCOs in general. But first, syempre, ato ang vision mission, ato ang goals, ato ang manang dapat i-integrate pod sa ato ang lesson 1. Because it's also very essential to get to know the vision and mission of UNESCOs, its vision, its goals ni UNESCOs as part of its history, okay? And it's there for a reason. So, let us try to refresh ourselves. No, the mission of UNESCOs is to envision a skillful and productive manpower, qualified and competent professionals endowed with leadership qualities, commitment to public service, a common shared values, and capacities to integrate and use new knowledge and skills in various vocations and professions to meet the challenges of the new millennium. So basically, ang mission nila ang sa school, no, is to make sure that they deliver quality education so that their students, when they graduate, they will be endowed, no, with leadership qualities, no, with these values wherein you are able to bring, you will be able to bring this one to your respective industries kung diin nyo gusto magtrabaho, and you will become competent professionals, okay? Meaning, out of all the professionals and even applicants out there, mag-stand out jud ang product ni UNESCOs because that is the mission of the school. Let us proceed to the vision. So the vision is to train and develop semi-skilled manpower, middle-level professionals, and competent and qualified leaders in the various professions, responsive to the needs and requirements of the service areas, providing appropriate and relevant curricular programs and offerings, research projects, and entrepreneurial activities, extension services, and develop progressive leadership to effect socioeconomic change, thereby improve the quality of life. So, the vision of the school, to mirror also its mission. So again, no, develop to train you so that you'll become semi-skilled, no? At the same time, you'll become competent, again, competent professionals, qualified leaders in your respective professions. So, dili lang siya para lang sa tourism or sa HRM, nga mahimo sila competent professional, but sa tanan, no? Sa tibong kabilugan sa mga programs nga gin-offer sa UNESCO. Okay? Now, for the institutional outcomes, this is actually in your core syllabus, no? If you can just refer to our core syllabus. So, at the end of the program, HRM, okay, you'll be able to demonstrate logical thinking, critical judgment, and independent decision-making on any confronting situations. You'll be able to demonstrate necessary knowledge, skills, and desirable attitudes expected of one's educational level and field of discipline. Not only that, you'll be able to exhibit necessary knowledge, skills, and desirable attitudes in research. So, why do you think na research-based kayo sa UNESCO's, no? Because that's the trend nowadays in education. Even CHED is pushing towards research. Although, wala man natin siya na-integrate kayo sa ito ang subject, but in maybe in other subjects, we're able to integrate research, no, in our respective industries, no? In my school, I'm teaching research, and I always highlight this to my students that the importance of having tourism research is that we identify existing problems in the tourism industry and we find solutions to address it so that, you know, it will be helpful to the community, to the city tourism office. So it's not just there for compliance nga makagraduate ang research, but it's actually a way to improve the quality of life, whether it may be in the tourism industry, hospitality industry ba na siya. So mapo na ang gusto ni UNESCO's nga outcomes sa ilang mga products, sa ilang graduates, once they finish or once you finish your HM program. HM program is your course, so, no? Okay, in college, we call subjects as courses, and we call our course, which is BSHM or BSTM, as program. When every time we will ask, what program are you? No, so I'm from BSHM program or sa business ad. And then the course that I am attending now is CARES 101, Local Mindedness and Global Competitiveness. So, and the next is to exhibit proactive and collaborative attributes in diverse fields, manifest abilities and willingness to work well with others, either in the practice of one's profession or community involvement, without compromising legal and ethical responsibilities and accountabilities. So basically, the goal of UNESCO's is to produce well-rounded individuals that are competent enough to work in the industry. Sa MUA, since we are a Catholic institution here in CSR, sa San Carlos, our school, no, school outcomes na mo, no, or amo ang institutional outcomes is produced of Christ-centered Augustinian Recollect graduates. Okay, we are from the Augustinian Recollect order. So, similar raman sa inyong institutional outcomes ang amua pong institutional goals and outcomes, but only difference lang is we add Christ-centered individuals, okay? Okay, kung na, no, very important, kina-highlight na sa mga Catholic non-sectarian schools ang religious education. So, in this course, CARES 101 is to help students understand the history of Northern Negro State College of Science and Technology, or as what we know now, kay bag-o education, State University of Northern Negros, or SUN, okay, which is in Sagay, Negros Occidental. However, there are several campuses man, no, nearby Sagay and even outside, no, outside Sagay, no, like Escalante. And Negros Occidental from ancient times to present as a base for shaping and bettering the future. So this module or this slides focuses on major topics in history, including social, cultural, economic, and political development. Sorry for the technical error there. And their interrelations thereof. The contents of this slide consider chronologically and thematic relationship of events in time and space. Syempre, when we study history class, hindi man na pwede mag-una ang present day, no? It has to begin chronological. And it has to start from, you know, when did it all start? How did the UNASCOS came to be? And before din siya nahimog ni UNASCOS, daghan kaayog na agian ang UNASCOS. No, it has many names, no? Nahimo siya og extension campus ni ISCOF. It started off as a old barangay high school, and eventually through time, no, with the grace of God and the hard work of the people and also with the Marañons, eventually nahimo siya og UNASCOS. And with the hard work of your teachers, the admin, the staff, even you as students, karon nahimo na po siya State University of Northern Negros. And again, for us to truly appreciate history, we have to know our roots. Okay? So our learning outcome is, syempre, you have to trace the history of UNASCOS. As students coming from this school, it's important that not only that you study the history of Negros Occidental, the history of Sagay, or even an entire Philippines, because, you know, that is expected for hospitality students. We are more inclined in social studies because, you know, when people are going to us, like foreigners, no, they don't really know about Sagay. They don't really know about Negros Occidental. And you, as a native born in this province, you will eventually be asked, especially during your internship, or you will have your manasya ng OJT within sa Negros Occidental. So, syempre, tourism student ka, you have to know these things. That's why we have Philippine geography. Oh, no, sorry. Hospitality students, I rather. That's why we have, I don't know if you have Philippine geography, no, but in tourism, they have like Philippine geography, global geography. It's important that we are aware of what is around us, okay? So, syempre, come up with as students of the UNASCOS, it's very important. Okay, knowing your roots, where you come from, before you learn of the culture and history of others. So, according, no, to Michael Crichton, if you don't know history, then you don't know anything. Because when we pursue, or let's say, proceed with our lives class, no, as we go with our respective lives class, we learn from our experiences in the past. And that is just an example of history. Why do you think nga, sorry. Why do you think nga nayoban nga mga for example, no, like sa business, why do you think every time there are accidents or there are concerns nga matabo sa business, nga ano gina jot down nila sa ilahang ginalog na nila silang logbook or na sila gina write an narrative report, and why do they keep it? So that in the future, when that kind of situation or let's say problem will arise again, they will go to their archives and look for that narrative report, and they will know exactly what to do. So in our history, we know what should be avoided, what should be pursued. Kay mo pa na, no, di ba? Mo pa na sa to ang saying, no, nga, we learn from our mistakes, di ba? Kay syempre, we learn as we go by, we go by with our lives, no? Kay wala may ingon nga pag abot ni pagbutwa nimo sa kalibutan, you know everything na. So you learn things through experience, and the more that you immerse yourself with different experiences, you grow wiser. Not knowledgeable, but wiser. Wise is different from being knowledgeable. Being wise is being, you know, it goes beyond knowledge. Knowledge can be learned sa school, but wisdom or being wise, no, you can acquire that one through experiences. And even if you are still young, let's say you're 20, 22, 19, if you've experienced a lot of things, even hardships in life, the more you become wiser. Because the more you are able to know Ah, okay. Lisod yung kinabuhi, no? Mo ni siya mga angay na ko nga i-avoid or dapat maningkamot yung ko so that I would, you know, make my life better. O, yung ana. So, mana, if you don't know history, then you don't know anything. Because in history, that is where we learn what to avoid and what to pursue. Okay? What should be avoided. Natabo ni siya in the past sa ako, so I will not do it again. Things like that. So, we did talk about the importance of history, no? So, why is it important to study history? We all live in the present and we plan for the future. Even if we are scared and we are afraid of the future, we try to be prepared for it by living also in the present and planning for the future so that when the future comes, we already know what to do, okay? And we are already prepared. But how do we understand where we're going and what progress looks like? So to know exactly where you're going, you first need to understand where you have come from. Oh, another na po na to nga ko ano, like katong kaho sa Rizal nga, ang hindi marunong lumingon sa pinanggalingan ay hindi makakarating sa kanilang paroroonan. So things like that, no? So if you don't know how to look back, marang po siya ka ng looking back at your roots, no? If you are not humble enough to look back kung diin ka nagikan, para sa nagung kuna, dato na ka, diba? If you do not know how to look back sa mong humble beginnings, then you would surely not be able to get to where you are now. Kay, mura na, ano ka nang murag, you forget being grateful na, so yung ana. Although history mo na itong historyahan, no? But anyway, so na siya. To know exactly where you're going, you first need to understand where you come from. First, you need to have an appreciation of history, your roots, your humble beginnings. And not just in history in totality, but even in life. Okay? I first started ani, you know, and it's very humbling to know nga, I come from this one, nya karon lahi na ako karon kananay growth. So, mama na siya. So, history is one of the most respected and most valuable academic subjects that you will learn. And sometimes it saddens me because, you know, we have political leaders who will try to change history, change the course of history because it does not work on their favor. And when you look at it, sometimes, mo na, you know, history is written by the victors, etc., etc. But if you look past, you know, political agendas, history is there because, you know, things happened. Well, it may be a good situation or a bad situation, but it was intended to happen and it has been recorded in history books so that we can learn from it or the future generation can learn from it. No, mabitaw na siya nga. What is nice in Germany? Sorry, yung sabo kayong sa kwarto. Sorry kayo. So, ang sa Germany, they teach, you know, what happened to the Jews. Ang sa Japan, I do not know if they're teaching what happened to World War II. But ang natabo sa Germany is, di ba, katong mga atrocities nga ginbuhat nila sa mga Jews, itong mga concentration camps. If you are still familiar with world history, no, to natabo during World War, nga they segregate Jews, they torture them, they put them in gas chambers and let them inhale, you know, toxic gas and let them die. So, you know, the Germans were taught about the atrocities that they did during those times, and the future generation will be able to know, hala, bumrining gibuhat din sa amo ang mga ancestors sa una, no, nga kanang ila na sila gipang priso nga mga Jews, na sila gipang torture, gipang butang sa gas chambers, sa mga concentration camps, wala nila ginapakaon. So, at least, we are not going to do the same mistakes that our ancestors did because it's inhumane, no? Dili jud siya maayo, no, nga thing to do for this kind of race, no, sa mga Jews, no? So, muna siya, it's a valuable subject and it should be respected because, you know, in order for us to progress with our future, we must remember what happened in the past. So this guide takes a deep dive into the importance of learning history at school. So importante siya again, no, because we appreciate where we come from, if there are bad things na natabo sa past, at least kabaluto how to avoid it. Ang uban nga countries, they are very we call it whitewashing, no, nga wherein, for example, ang natabo sa Germans, they do not whitewash history. They accept and acknowledge that bad things happened in the past and they are the ones who are accountable for it. So so they learn that one in school so that they will avoid repeating the same mistakes in the future. In other countries, they whitewash. So when you talk about whitewash, kabalo sila nga, they colonize, kabalo sila nga, they have already tortured lots of people during colonizations, mga anak. Pero wala nila nag-i-appeal silang history lessons because they're afraid that they will be painted as the villain, no, or antagonist. Hindi sila ginahan makabalo ang future generations sa mga bad nga natabo sa past. So that's whitewashing. And in history, again, that should not happen. Kay, again, like what I've kept on saying since kanina pa, history should be there, whether it's good or bad. We do not need to whitewash it because it's intended for our future generation to be studied. And when our future generation learns what we did in the past, either they can make better decisions and avoid making bad decisions. Okay? Kay, ay, natabo ni sa past, man lang gibuhat, di nato na siya buhaton. Okay? So, muna siya. So, entire societies and the individuals within them benefit from gaining a deeper understanding of history. There are 6 benefits that your child, you know, but you as students will enjoy if you study history. And that is in our local-mindedness nga subject, no? Siyempre, dili lang ta history, tibuok dyan na to nga course class, no? After we learn the history up until Negros Occidental, we will proceed man with localization, its advantages, then with globalization. So, dili entirely like the whole na jud nga klase mag sige tag talk about history. There are times that we are going to talk about globalization, localization, okay, things like that. So, of course, syempre, one of those advantages in learning history is that you'll be able to develop an understanding of the world. Through history, we can learn how past societies, systems, ideologies, governments, cultures and technologies were built, how they operated, and how they have changed. In history, you know, we know that, especially when I taught transportation management and tourism, kanang pag-evolve sa transportation from steam-powered engines down to kung ano siya, powered na rin siya with oil, crudo, ano, up until pohon, no, powered lang siya with water and electricity. We already have Tesla gani for that, no nga. I-charge na lang gani siya. Yes, I think someone raising their hand. Tuplokan na goro. Okay. So, you'll be able to appreciate how, you know, societies, technology, evolve, no, from time. So, sa una, kuan lang, manual. Sa unang panahon, kuan lang ginagamit nila. Kanang steam-powered engines. Yeah, karun, nanaga ni Tesla, no? They don't need kuan na. Kanang gas, no, gasoline for it to run, no? You're just going to charge it. Ang uban, like sa Canada, they're planning to have, like, kanang hydro engine or kanang powered by water, okay? Sure, pinito if non-renewable, non-renewable, sorry. Correction, it's better if we have like renewable sources of, like kanang, for example, if atong source of fuel will be renewable, then that would be good for the environment. Ay, mga non-renewable, kaya di naman ito na siya mabawi once ma-deplete na ang sources, no? So, the rich history of the world helps us to paint a detailed picture of where we stand today. Developing your knowledge of history means developing your knowledge of all these different aspects of life. Children can learn about the pillars upon which different civilizations were built, including cultures and people different from their own. Last time I was teaching global culture, no? last semester, na-appreciate rin ako ang development. Like, for example, we were talking about the continent of Africa, and it's partly Mediterranean, especially sa babaw nung, like, Morocco, Egypt, yun ang mga Mediterranean countries, but still part of Africa. Ga-evolve siya over time, and you see, like, civilizations change, no? From flourishing civilizations down to, like, corrupt government. So, di rin mo na makuha nung, there are civilizations when they start from scratch, but then, nagkarindot siya ka madugayan na payoban nga mga countries nga, they used to be great civilizations, pero karun, dili na nindot, no? So, all this knowledge makes them more rounded people who are better prepared to learn in your academic subjects. And then, second benefit is you will become a more rounded person. History is full of stories. Although, sometimes, no, we get bored sa history. Most especially if we, you know, think and remember about dates. Nya, usahay ang uban kay kanang grabe siya ka detailed ang pagstorya nila sa history nga medyo, you know, you'll get sleepy na. But if you move past, no, the boring details in history and you try to appreciate, you know, highlights of the entire timeline, you will appreciate it na lagi kan siya diri din kamadugayan nag-improve na siya na many roads were built na na-expand na further ang city, so may ana. So there are some stories that are inspiring and uplifting. There are others that are chaotic and immoral. Like, there are stories behind why a certain festival came to be. It was brought because out of oppression, for example. So, napayoban nga history nga nindot po siya nga maka-inspire. Yep. Napayoban nga medyo dark, no? Nga cost many lives, or people were turned into slavery. So, mapo na. No? There are so many things that can happen in history. So, there are many vital lessons that you will learn. History also encourages a deeper understanding of difference. There are also lessons, both good and bad. So, again, no? Understanding history makes you a well-rounded person. And you have to understand that not all that comes from history nindot na tanan, no? Syempre, it's also important to learn about the bad things as well, because it makes you become more neutral, more open-minded. Mano natabo sa Germany, di ba? Although they were painted, pwede mo siya nga painted, kaya they were really the antagonist sa katunga part sa history, no? Because, you know, many lives were lost at their hands. But at least they're learning it sa schools, and they acknowledge their part in that, kuano, in that war, no? In the demise of several lives sa Jews, no? And then understand identity. Nations are made up of a collection of stories and legends. These stories shape the way we think about our country and our standing within it. History is where we learn about how great institutions are formed and how they've contributed to where we are today. And in fact, even your school, UNESCO's, from its humble beginnings, nga old barangay high school lang siya, up until karon nga nahimo na siya state university, it has contributed so much to the city. Kaya not only providing quality education, no, sa inyo ha, but also providing competent individuals that can work actually in Sagay and even outside of Sagay. For many of us, looking back at the incredible fellow countrymen is a way of establishing our own identity. When we look at our, you know, heroes in the past, martyrs, no, we learn our history and our identity. We find out who we are and what mark we can make on this world. You will also become inspired, no, syempre. So, those historical stories can also serve to inspire individuals to greatness. History remembers brilliant people and their heroic acts that have changed the shape of nations. You get a huge amount of motivation from learning about the inspirational events that make up where we are today. So, it takes one great story from the pages of history to light up children's imagination and spur them on to do great things. I remember I had a friend who wanted to become a lawyer, and I asked this person, why do you want to become a lawyer? Like, dili man siya align sa imuhang bachelor's degree. Well, he wanted to become a lawyer because when he heard about, you know, one of the stories in their Philippine history about the oppressions of the Filipinos, up until muna siya nung sa EDSA People Power, he was so moved by what he heard from his teacher that he decided that he wants to become a lawyer and, you know, fight for what is right and also defend those who were powerless, mga yung anak. And others, so they are interested. Like, me, no, the more, wow, kujulang kon. So, when I had an interest in reading history during my board exam review last year, I became so interested with it that every time that I travel to a new place, I go to their museum. Museums were not really, like, a thing for me sa una, no? Dili siya na ako na siya, like, cup of tea nga mong tujukong museum. Kay, basta mula agka, mall man siya na yung tuan, ka na mga picturesque nga mga sites. But every time that I go to a certain place, I really like to go to their museum and learn new things about it because, you know, the more na ko na basa ang history, the more na ko na appreciate, no, what it is, no, and especially what happened from different timelines. And it's really interesting that when you go to a museum and you see artifacts from the past, it's a very interesting thing to see, no. So yung ana, no, learning history can also spur curiosity, no, imagination sa uban, they want to do even more great things like become a lawyer baron, no, or work sa human sa like in the field of arts and sciences or humanities, may ngana. In my case, just there's a growth of interest ra, no, in learning history. Not necessarily jud nga expert naman jud, no, pero at least ka naman interested na lang ka sa history ba because of the things that you've read. And again, just like what I've said kanina nga sigug balik-balik, you learn from your mistakes. Again, those who cannot remember the past are condemned to repeat it. That is why I do not understand why people, when they know that, you know, he's following, pwede sana, no? No, syempre, I will not name names man, but, syempre, kanang kabalo na mga, daghan lang kayong natabuan ni sa past, and yet, you still want to continue it in the present times, even electing people who have done wrong in the past. So, mo po na siya. Those who cannot remember the past are condemned to repeat it. If we turn a blind eye, no, to the atrocities that happened. That is in the contrast of Japan and Germany. No, Germany would face, no, the horrible acts that they did in the past by allowing the future generation to learn from it, being taught in schools. Pero sa Japan, no, they avoid, no, mga yung anak nga kind of topics, kasi syempre, no, they also play a part nga sa mga many killings, no, sa natabo during World War. And again, dili lang ni siya between like sa Germany lang o sa Japan, even in our own country, no, there would be people who would try to whitewash our history because it does not work on their favor. And again, no, if we do not let our students or the younger generation learn from what happened in the past, the more we get blinded on what is happening, and katong mga tao nga responsible for it, they can just get away with it, no? They can just do whatever they want because gitangtang naman ang ilang mga bad deeds sa records of history. Okay? Mupo na siya. So, this quote by George Santayana, "Those who cannot remember the past are condemned to repeat it," is one of academia's most cited and paraphrased lines. And even gani up to sa mga misinformation sa internet, ginagamit siya sa maskin kinsa na lang nga tao ang ginahapak dira sa kana nga quote nga, "Those who cannot remember the past are condemned to repeat it." Nigiwala ng name ni George Santayana, no? Pero gikan siya na niya. Okay, ang sa internet mang good is, kuha ra kag quote dira, ihapak sa maskin kinsa nga nawong, then you will believe it. But that quote is actually originally from George Santayana. So it explains why everyone should study history. "The past is filled with warning signs. Previous people do not know how to govern, okay, or know how to make good decisions." No, natabo na kay di siya na siya maayo to start a war. And I think that is what US is trying to do now, no, nga. Sa una, USA is very aggressive, like every time nga na ay conflict between countries, mubat in judayon siya. Because he is capable of, you know, butting in, powerhouse pa man siya. But now, China is a sleeping dragon. It's already a bigger powerhouse than USA. To avoid future world wars, simba ko lang, mo nang wala nagakuan kayo ang US po, no? It's just trying raman also to avoid mistakes from the past nga. Muna, may matabo, mag-butt-in, mag-away na dayon. Yun. Yeah. Dili ra ba ingon nga mag-away sila sila, no? There are so many civilians that will be affected as well in the war. In war, wala dyan madaog. No? Even katong mga civilians, looy ka sila kay, they will be, you know, they'll be caught in the crossfire. So we must be able to reflect on the events that built up to them, learn from mistakes made, and resist and question if we see similar patterns emerging. Mo na dapat unta. If we see patterns emerging, parehas ra man sa una, oy. Dictator man pud ni ang iyang kuan niya. Parehas sige sila pattern. Pero syempre, you know, I'm not saying human as we are, ha, but you know, people who are not literate enough to understand, may na siya. They would just not resist anymore. Kikapoy na sila. They don't question anymore if there are patterns emerging from the past nga. Natabo naman yun sa past. Oy, pero wala pa. Bulag-bulag rang mga tao. Mapod na. Parehas ani, no? Muna yung mga natabo sa past, no? Katong na-breed sa Philippine Film Center. No, muna siya si Hitler ng atrocity sa concentration camps where, you know, Jews are being forced to do labor o niya ubanan nila do experimentations, di sila ginapakaon, ginatorture, maniwang kayo o niya once nga muna, no, they dili na magamit, they put them into gas chambers until mamatay sila. Okay? And if we do not know, if we do not learn from our past, like what happened here, no? Ang natabuan ni class is, muna, this is history, ha? There is no political inclination. I do not care if unsay imuhang gipili nga presidente during the election, but this is really what happened sa Philippine Film Center. And I think it's enough already, no, nga, why we question, why we allow these people to still roam around, given that there are so many people who died during their time. Okay? So, what happened in the Manila Film Center, no, when isyo ka nung tabo, is there was an earthquake, okay? And there were a lot of structural damage, no, in the building, kay gagamit man sila mga low cost materials, kay gadali man sila. Okay, mobitaw na nga kanang ang Manila Film Center is murag gimo siya og murag source for ghost stories because there are a lot of people actually who died. Okay, now what happened here is during the time when Imelda Marcos was still the first lady during the time of the presidency of Ferdinand Marcos. So, syempre, kuan man. Duha man na no, naman tay Iron Fist. Si Ferdinand Marcos, he led the country, but kanang mga infrastructures built around the Philippines, that was under Imelda Marcos. Tanan yung mga yangungo, tanan yung mga kuan. Matuman siya na, no? Kung gusto siya magpa-build og bridge, magpa-build siya og Coconut Palace, no? Tanan ana behind kuar naman na siya good. So dili, although si Ferdinand Marcos ang galit sa country, pero yung wife jud may majority ang maoyga buot sa mga pag-build sa infrastructures. And Imelda at that time, she wanted to make Manila as the cultural center of the East, which could compete to France sa Cannes Film Festival. Now, in that time, no, she wanted her ambition to be realized. Like, she wanted, like, the theater, no, the film center to host the Miss Universe pageant. So, since gadali man siya, sige siya, gadali siya, 3 months, I think, no? Three months. And then, pilara ang budget nga gi-allot, ana. Ang material si gamit is dili siya of high quality, no? Kaya syempre, dinalian pod, no? Within 3 months, lago ka maghimuan ng dako kaayo nga film center. And then, materials are like subpar, like, dili siya exactly like good materials po. What happened is, 1,000 workers, no? Should finish the grand lobby in 72 hours. Nga masking dapat 6 weeks tani siya, imagine, no? Unya, muna, dili man durable ang foundation, dili man durable pod ang material. So what happened is a lot of people died, okay? Half of the employees sila, alang body, half ana na nakuan, no, na buried, no. And it is said nga muna na mix sa materials, no, sa quick drying cement ang mga uban nga workers. Muna yung nakita. Kaya gipadali man. Imagine if you're going to make the grand lobby in 6 weeks, gi-shortcut siya to 72 hours. You have to finish everything in 3 months. And a lot of workers were trapped in the quick drying cement. And muna, naghan pa ng uban nga muna, igo, no? And na trapped. Half of their body was buried. So there were 168 who died in this tragedy and were buried in the cement. That's why they said it's said to be haunted. Kaya it is buried in, they were buried in cement. No, within the Manila Film Center. Sa time po ni Hitler, oh, syempre kabalo naman mo. Mga concentration camps, not just discrimination of Jews, but even killing sa mga Jews, no? And he, di na ko maihap kung pila daghan kay namatay ng mga tao in the hands of the Nazis, no? In the hands of Hitler. So, again, it's important to study history. You will remember from past mistakes and dili lang siya ingon nga tuntun lang ta for the sake it's a requirement. But eventually, hopefully, we will use this as our basis to not really make the same mistakes as our ancestors did, no? Umito na nag-ed sa revolution because of the atrocities that happened. And when we allow, you know, things to happen again, then surely we would experience same things sa Japan if we allow things to happen, if we do not question it, no, if we do not learn from history, so mana. If your child or if you study history, you'll be able to identify when society is going down perilous routes, perilous is dangerous, and contribute towards getting it back on track. Okay, next is you'll be able to develop transferable skills. So history is a respected academic pursuit that challenges our intellect. Students must analyze information that may not have one clear interpretation before offering a balanced conclusion. So it's not just, you know, reading something and then you would conclude immediately. It entails a lot of critical thinking. When you study history, you try to understand it, find further sources, and once everything is already clear to you, usa pa ka muhatag og balanced conclusion. Di siya pwede nga study history with just one sitting. It takes a lot of time. Critical thought is the heart of every challenging intellectual pursuit. So the ability to question and evaluate information is one that applies to workplaces in many countries. So how to study history? History is not about memorizing a list of facts and dates. It's about interpretation and analysis of information around subjects which often have no right or wrong answers. Still, there are plenty of effective methods for studying history. So there are only three, no? First is to connect events together. History is shaped by a list of chronological events. Chronological pasunod. So when studying seismic shifts in a culture or country, it is important that you know what key events contributed to this. So di ba yun sa tanang higayon, like from day 1, day 2, day 3, mo siya na yung sadihan. When we study history, we only highlight those who are important events and what led to this important event. Like for example, unsay naka-trigger sa World War 1, oh, pag assassinate sa katong Archduke, no? Of Austria. So pag posisyon mo na trigger na dayon. So katong mga important mga highlight events, those are what triggered two important events later in the in our history. Okay? So it can lead to a daunting list of times, dates, and people to learn. And tinuod yun na, when we study history, it's very tiring because you have to remember dates, you have to remember people. And what you have to remember lang is who are those important people. Like for example, there are 5 people that really helped contributed to the establishment of UNESCO's as an institution. But who is really like the key person dyan na nila tanan? We have the Marañón, di ba? Marañóns, no? So sila dyan na ang kuan. The sugod tanan. Eventually, dyan, like although naamput ang uban, no? But at least you try to highlight only the important events, the important people. One popular method for doing this involves making your connections to develop the full picture with your syempre with you as a student. Note down different events, facts, and people that played a role in significant historical event. On display key information. Okay, focus only on valuable information and retain it for exams. Especially sa tong mga quizzes class, no, there are times that labi nang kanang history of Sagay, history of Negros Occidental, daghan na kayo ng mga dates involved, no. Kay ga-evolve man ang syudad, like post-Japanese, na ay industrial, American occupation, mga things like that. So, you have to remember only the important ones, no? Kanigining sa slides na ko, wala pa man dyan siya na-adiri, no? Pero, sa slides na ko sa History of Sagay, taas kayo siya actually niya. Ako rin gipang kuha ka to ng mga importante. Okay, para dili po ta magtagbaw o ko ano, magtagbaw dyan o memorize tanan kung apilan pa siya ito ang mga dili dyan kayo highlight. Okay, para sa post-Japanese war, naghanap kayo natabu ato nga time, nagag mga camps gipang tukod around Sagay. Ako rin gipang highlight ka to ng mga importante. Okay, ano, kanisya used to be like prison camp, no, for mga prisoners of war, maya na. Lahat itong mga others pa dyan nga, nag-establish sila kampo diri mo ni mauna. Kato ng mga prisoners nga na-caught, for example, asa sila dapat nagtukod, no, o ka ng resistance camp against the Japanese, so mga yung anak. Flashcards are also an excellent way, but again, it really depends on the student in what way they can familiarize history, no, and its details. Soak up books and films. Sa History of Sagay, I will probably show you a video on its humble beginnings. It's important man nga nakita siya mo ng mga black and white should nga gikan doon sa mga 1821, nung sa panadira, nung nga karaan na siya kaayo. Nga ka nang, at least na ma-appreciate niyo further nga, ay nga ni dahil niya among lugar sa una pa siyong panahon. Okay? Kaya it's filled with real-life stories, no? Maybe it could be in the form of books. Sa ato nga case, it's in the form of mana, klase at the same time. Na yung mga videos available, no? Okay. So, for the history of the UNESCO's, we are just going to take a very short break of 5 minutes. Kaminom sa kaug water, then we can continue after the break. Okay? 5 minutes lang. Basta, mag-start ka og school, no? Few lang na imong graduates. I remember when we started our pioneer program sa tourism, no? 5 lang imong estudyante, yan yung undang pa dyan ang tulo. Duhara dyan yung graduate tawon. But karon no, nagdaghan na mi up to 30, up to 60, almost 100 na amo ang first year. So, syempre, no, it's a big difference with ang private school kay medyo mahal man dyan tuition, no? We cannot achieve tagpila ka sections ang freshmen. But it's a very big thing na for us to reach at least 2 sections sa first year. So, na siya na, no? We started lang dyan sa small. Wala man naingon nga. pag first yung open ditso dayo na. That's also what happened to Nunascos, no, in its humble beginnings. When it first became an old Sagay Barangay High School, 10 lang iyang pioneer graduates. Ingat lang. May nag-hang. Oh, in 1978, Old Sagay Barangay High School was then converted into a municipal high school. So, ilang head designate na is already Mrs. Priscilla L. Amar. In that same year, Mayor Alfredo G. Marañon Jr. and Dr. Elpidio M. Icamina, President of Iloilo State College of Fisheries, dili di isat no ISCOF, di correct me. Correction, it's what it was ISCOF, no, which can be found in Barotac, Nuevo Iloilo, signed the historical memorandum of agreement that transformed Old Sagay Barangay High School into an extension campus of ISCOF. So, when you talk about extension campus, para sa nang ang Nunascos, no, dira ba siya namang start sa Sagay? Yeah, they're planning to have an extension campus in San Carlos. So, muna siya, that's an extension campus. Pero ilang main dito dyan sa Sagay, kaya dira man siya na siya nag-start. So, si Mayor Marañon, kaya siya man dyan nagsugod sa Old Sagay Barangay High School, man ang gitawag siya Father of Nunascos, he decided na nga to expand further, no, the access to education sa mga Sagay nun. So, I don't know if you're called Sagay nun, so, but sa mga taga-Sagay, no, by having a MOA, no, an agreement together with ISCOF or Iloilo State College of Fisheries. 5 years later, the passage of BP 359 on March 3, 1983, which was authored and sponsored by then Assemblyman. So from kuano, from municipal mayor na himog Assemblyman si Alfredo G. Marañon Jr., he converted the municipal high school into the Iloilo State College of Fisheries Sagay branch. So dili na siya extension or municipal high school, but gihimo na siya og Sagay branch, ISCOF Sagay branch. Professor Pipito Bedia became its first designated officer in charge. Rapod siyang program head, no? In 1985, the college offered a technical course in fisheries, the Diploma in Fishery Technology. So, ang vision ni Marañon at this time is not to not only offer high school education in Sagay, but also college. That is why he had a agreement with Iloilo State College of Fisheries para mahimo na siya another branch, no, anang school, para maka-offer ang Sagay o college education sa ilang lugar. There were 10. So, di ba 10 kabuok, no? Ang pioneer nga graduate sa high school, sa Old Sagay Barangay High School, nahimo na siya og kanang College of Fisheries Extension Campus, pulo pod, no? 10 pod ang ilang pioneering students. And during the morning, high school, sa gabi eh, kay college. 4 years later, under the officership of Artemio Violeta, baccalaureate courses were offered. So, dili nang diplomas of fisheries ang ilang offer. Nanay Bachelor of Science in Secondary Education, Major in Biology and General Science, and Bachelor of Science in Fisheries, Major in Aquaculture. A year after, daghan na pud kaayo og mga specialization. Na siya po yung mga Bachelor of Science in Fisheries, pero nanay specialization, no nga. Like fish processing. O kung dili ka ginahag fish processing, pwede mong specialization marine fisheries. Para sa gano'n, para sa ng BSBA, majorship ni mo financial. Or kung di ka ginahag financial, pwede ka mag-marketing. O silang Bachelor of Science in Fisheries, pwede coastal resource management, marine fisheries, depende sa unsa imong preference. This time, the college was under the leadership of Mrs. Wine S. Silva, who was appointed officer in charge in 1990. To further boost the development of the college and make it more responsive to the academic demands of the area, dili lang college ang gi-offer na later on sa Iskof. Iskof pa itong tawag ani ha, kay wala pa man siyang tawag una na Skos. So, ga-offer po sila graduate school programs. Unsa man ni mga graduate school programs? Masteral, no? Masters. So, they offered Master of Arts in Educational Management since they have already Bachelor of Science in Education, diba? So, napod sila yung Masters sa Educational Management, major in Vocational Productivity, and mo siya pinaka-common, maski asa ka nga, skwilahan, offered na sila Master in Public Administration, labi na kung State University or College, which started in the second semester of the school year 1994-1995. Tandaan ninyo ha, kanos anag sugod ang Old Sagay 1970. As early as 1970, dira nag-start ang Old Sagay Barangay High School. Dayon, pila ka years later, di ba, 1978, after 8 years, nahimo na siya into a, kanang Municipal High School. Then, later on, sa same rapod nga tuig, after siya mag Municipal High School, nahimo po siya, nag-decide sila to make it as a extension campus sa ISCOF so that they can offer diploma courses, like associate barod, no? Sa right after high school, may mga diploma courses for college. And then, not until 1983 pa, no, nga, muna na siya, na-pass na ang BP 359. So, si Maranyo na Japan ang nag-author, anak. Ay, siya man siya na nangusog, no, to make a school in Sagay. Siya man siya nagsugod sa Old Sagay Barangay High School. So, siya po ang nag-pass, no, nag-author sa passage of BP 359 to make the Municipal High School into an ISCOF Sagay branch. So, not until 1990, so manano, 1983 pa to siya nga nahimog ISCOF Sagay branch. And then 1985, nag-offer sila diploma in fishery technology. Pag-abot og 1990, nag-offer na sila og additional pajud nga specialization. Nanay mga bachelor's degree offered, and then kaning mga bachelor's degree especially sa fisheries na anay mga majorship or specialization gi-offered 1990. Pag 1994, dira na ang masteral nagsugod. So amat-amat lang, no. From 1970, again ha, highlight ato important dates. 1970 nag-start ang Old Sagay Barangay High School. 1978 muna na siya ang pag-start sa Municipal High School, and then nag-decide sila to make it as a extension campus, no? Until sa mga 1980s, dira na na ang mahimo siya og sorry, kindly mute your microphone. Okay. So nahimo siya og Sagay, ISCOF Sagay branch, offered sila bachelor's degree. Not until 1990 nga nag-add sila additional specializations sa Bachelor of Science and Fisheries, and then 1994 masteral na siya. Okay? Kailang gi-offered. Okay? Not only that, other than like having a MOA with ISCOF so that may mo sila extension branch, there was also a consortium program. Unsa man yung consortium program? Yung itag consortium gani class na ay duha ka schools nga mag-join forces together to open a program into another school. Marago nag-mag-join forces abi ang Nonescos o ang Sagay para mo-open sila o MIT or DIT sa either sa CSR, no, or either sa Nonescos, no. Mag-join forces ang duha ka eskwelahan to offer graduate school programs. In this case, si ISCOF or Iloilo State College of Fisheries and Aklan State College of Agriculture nag-coordinate silang duha. These are two different schools. They coordinate together, okay, to offer consortium programs. So either Master in Fisheries Technology, Major in Aquaculture, okay? Kay ngano ga join forces sila, ma'am? It could be that ISCOF do not have enough teachers or qualified teachers to teach masteral in fisheries. So, manguwa sila sa lain nga eskwelahan nga mo'y motodlo and even help open the programs for them. The same school year also gave birth to a new bachelor's degree, which is Bachelor of Science in Marine Transportation, which was made possible through effort of then Congressman Manuel H. Pew and I don't have to pronounce his last name, no, and College President Dr. Elpidio A. Locsin Jr. So the ISCOF ASCA graduate studies. So ngano ISCOF ASCA, kahit that's two schools, consortium program and ano, Iloilo State College of Fisheries, Aklan State College of Agriculture. So gakombine forces sila to offer a consortium program. But if you think about it, it did not last long. Okay? Kay na-terminate siya until 1996. So, di ba, nagsugod ilahang master's degree 1994. Nya, ningundang siya pagka 1996. So, it did not actually last long. Ang ilang consortium programs, gani kay, wala siya nagduga, pila jud ka, tuig nga, until today, no, wala na jud. So, but continued by the college as one of its program. 2 years later, a postgraduate program, so nag-offer na po sila doctorate, under ISCOF pa niya, dili na ISCOS, Doctor in Rural Development with different fields of specialization was offered. 1998 made a special mark on the history of the college. On January 9, bag-ulan ta nag-celebrate sa to ang anniversary, no? As Northern Negros State College of Science and Technology. Okay, Republic Act 8448 became a law which converts Iloilo State College of Fisheries Sagay Branch into Northern Negros State College of Science and Technology. Planat 26 years? Is it 26 years already? No, so 26 years, no? Correct me if I'm wrong. Since UNESCO became UNESCO, no? Na change ang name from ISCOF to UNESCO's. And karon na change na po siya from UNESCO's to State University of Northern Negros. The historical law was authored and sponsored by Honorable Alfredo G. Marañón Jr., representative of the 2nd Congressional District of the Province of Negros Occidental. This earned for the congressman the distinction Father of UNESCO's. Because he started it all. He started with Old Barangay. Old Sagay Barangay High School. Then he encouraged ISCOF to sign a MOA to make the Old Sagay Barangay High School or the Municipal High School in Sagay into ISCOF Sagay Branch. And later on, he authored, no, Republic Act 8448. So he authored several laws, no, nga mahimo og UNESCO's, no, its own identity na, not an extension branch anymore, not Sagay Branch anymore, but its own name of Negros, UNESCO's, no, Northern Negros State College of Science and Technology. So, we will continue with its presidents. Kay kada president, the university president, they have their own achievements over the past years. May mga new programs gi-offered. So, we will just continue this one next meeting. And then we will have an activity. Questions? Hindi siya kaya sa kong powers, no? Paos ako, ugmani, wala ko itingog. So, do you have any questions? Things you would like to clarify? Okay, if not, again, so sorry if wala pa ko yung na-produce nga attendance. I will not be calling your names for now. Yes? Kaynard?
Ay, excuse me, miss. This is Kim. Yes, miss. Thank you, miss. Kilala mo ka. Actually, miss, wala ko ka-kwan kayo sa tanan ni mga ginkwan. Pero may kwan niya sa YouTube, miss, nga na-record. Kaya dito na lang kumakwan kay hina kayo ding signal as in, miss.
Okay. I have recorded the session, so I will upload this recording tonight. And then I will upload this one to our Google Classroom alongside with the slides. Okay. Don't worry about the attendance again. Oh, this is generated naman automatically by our Google Meet. So I will just take a picture, then send it over to our group chat. Okay? I will just call your names probably next week kay mo mapag-encode sa ako ang student assistant no sa mga names ninyo sa ko ang class attendance. So base next week pa rin ako na matawag inyong name. So sorry. Bago na po ko naabot gikan sa ko ang kuan trip, so wala dyan ako na siya naasikaso for the entire weekend. So anyway, you don't have to worry about attendance. At the end of this session, it will automatically generate, okay? Kung wala na tayong mga pangutana, let us end our class with a prayer. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever, Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, Amen. Thank you so much, everyone. So sorry to cut our discussion short. Mentioned to you guys sa power sa Pluton lang, no? Thank you so much, everyone. See you next week. Bye, everyone.
Bye, miss.